गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू जीके टुडे। आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेरी वेल एंड टुडे विल बी डिस्कसिंग द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट एमसीक्यूज फॉर 28th एंड 29th ऑफ अप्रैल 2024। लेट्स स्टार्ट विद आवर सेशन। द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, रिसेंटली विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैज डेवलप्ड इंडियाज लाइटेस्ट बुलेट प्रूफ जैकेट। हियर करेक्ट आंसर वुड बी DRDO, that is A option. The DRDO has achieved a milestone by creating the nation's lightest bulletproof jacket, which has been designed to withstand the level 6 threat of the BIS ammunition. Okay, so recently it was tested at IBRL Chandigarh, and it incorporates novel materials and processes for enhanced protection. Okay, so the front hard armor panel utilizes a monolithic ceramic plate with polymer backing, which provides both durability as well as comfort for operatives during the mission, and it is affirmed by the Ministry of Defense. Okay, so DRDO has developed India's lightest bulletproof jacket. Okay, in the next slide we will see some of the important organizations that were in news. The first question is, recently which organization released the trends in world military expenditure 2023 report? This report has been released by SIPRI. SIPRI stands for Stockholm International Peace Research Institute, and in this report they said that India ranks at fourth position in terms of military expenditure. Which countries are at the top position, or you can say at the top three position? These countries are US, China and Russia. Okay, recently which organization has developed the carbon-carbon nozzle for the rocket engines? This is ISRO. Man-portable anti-tank guided missile weapon system recently seen in the news is developed by which organization? It has been developed by DRDO. Akash Tir air defense system recently seen in the news is developed by which organization? This system has been developed by BEL, full form is Bharat Electronics Limited. Recently which organization has partnered with Panasonic Energy to create a joint venture for producing lithium ion cells in India? This is Indian Oil Corporation Limited. They have partnered with Panasonic Energy so that they can create a joint venture for producing lithium ion cells in India. Okay, recently which bank has signed an agreement with Tata Power Solar Systems to provide the loans under the PM Surya Ghar Muft Bijli Yojana? Here correct answer is A option, Indian Bank. Indian Bank, based in Chennai, has partnered with Tata Power Solar System to offer the loans under PM Surya Ghar Muft Bijli Yojana, and this initiative was launched by Prime Minister Narendra Modi on 13th of February 2024. Basic aim is to provide free electricity to 1 crore households in India through rooftop solar system. Okay, so eligible households can receive up to 300 units of free electricity monthly, and the government has allocated 75,021 crore rupees for this scheme. Okay, correct answer is Indian Bank. They have signed this agreement with Tata Power Solar System to provide loans under the PM Surya Ghar Muft Bijli Yojana. Now our keyword is Yojana, and in the next slide we will see some of the important schemes that were in news. Mahatari Vandana Yojana, recently seen in the news, is launched by which Indian state? This is the scheme of Chhattisgarh state. Mukhyamantri Harit Vikas Chhatravritti Yojana, recently seen in the news, is launched by which Indian state? This is a kind of scholarship scheme and it is given by Himachal Pradesh state. Mukhyamantri Kanya Sumangla Yojana, recently seen in the news, is an initiative of which Indian state? This is the scheme of UP. Neen Galum Nalama scheme, recently seen in the news, is launched by which Indian state? This is the scheme of Tamil Nadu. Recently which state government announced a special scheme for the laborers and the street vendors named as Mukhyamantri Vishwakarma Pension Yojana? So Vishwakarma Pension Yojana belongs to Rajasthan state and it is dedicated to the laborers and the street vendors. Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, CSIR, as a part of the Earth Day celebrations, recently installed India's biggest climate clock at which place? So as a part of Earth Day celebration, CSIR has unveiled India's largest climate clock at its headquarters in New Delhi. and this initiative aims to raise awareness about the climate change. And here Professor Chetan Singh, who's from IIT Bombay, emphasized the urgency for energy literacy among the citizens, urging them to minimize the energy consumption. Okay, so on this particular day, they have installed India's biggest climate clock at New Delhi. When do we observe the Earth Day? Answer is 22nd of April, right? And this year the theme was planet versus plastics. Okay, now let's see some of the important locations that can be asked in your examination. Mulla Periyar Dam, recently seen in the news, is located in which Indian state? This dam lies in Kerala. Tail Valley Wildlife Sanctuary, recently seen in the news, is located in which Indian state? It lies in Arunachal Pradesh. Mount Ruang, recently seen in the news, is located in which country? It lies in Indonesia. Lake Kariba, recently seen in the news, is located between which two countries? This lake lies between Z2Z, or you can say Zambia to Zimbabwe. Murya tribe, recently seen in the news, primarily located in which states? Murya tribe is predominantly found in Telangana, along with Andhra Pradesh, Chhattisgarh and Odisha. Okay, these are the four states where you can find the Murya tribe. Recently, which country hosted the Sustainable Finance for Tiger Landscapes Conference? So, on Earth Day 2024, Bhutan leads the Sustainable Finance for Tiger Landscape Conference, striving to raise $1 billion in a decade to safeguard the crucial tiger habitats. And this event, in collaboration with the Royal Government of Bhutan and the Tiger Conservation Coalition, highlights sustainable finance, United Nations Global Biodiversity Framework, and essential public-private partnerships for tiger conservation. Okay, simply we have to remember that which country has hosted the Sustainable Finance for Tiger Landscape Conference? Answer would be Bhutan. Fine. Now, in the next slide, we will see some international current affairs. Recently, which country passed the Safety of Rwanda Asylum and E-Migration Bill? Here, correct answer would be United Kingdom, that is UK. UK has passed the Safety of Rwanda Bill, permitting the deportation of some asylum seekers to Rwanda so as to deter illegal entry via the small boats. Okay. So, this bill follows a treaty that enhances the migrant protection, and flights deporting migrants for processing in Rwanda are set to commence in next 10 to 12 weeks. So, it marks a significant step in UK immigration policy, right? So, UK has passed the Safety of Rwanda Asylum and Immigration Bill. Mount Elgon National Park, recently seen in the news due to Marburg virus, is located in which country? This park lies in the country Kenya. And why it came into news? Because the experts fear that the Keetum, which is the world's deadliest cave in Mount Elgon National Park, could harbor the next pandemic. Okay, actually Marburg virus is flagged as epidemic prone by the World Health Organization, and Marburg virus disease is a severe hemorrhagic fever that affects the humans and primates, and it is caused by a unique zoonotic RNA virus related to Ebola, right? So it is transmitted through bat inhabited caves, and it spreads via direct contact with infected bodily fluids, raising concerns about potential outbreaks and the need for heightened vigilance, right? So you can be asked about the location of Mount Elgon National Park. It lies in Kenya. Recently, which country hosted the first international rainbow tourism conference? Here answer is Nepal, and the discussions were regarding LGBTQ plus community. Recently, which Gulf country launched their first ever Hindu radio broadcast? This is the country Kuwait. Rampage missile, recently seen in the news, is developed by which country? This missile belongs to Israel. Okay. Next is Voyager 1 spacecraft, recently seen in the news, is a space probe launched by which space organization? So here correct answer is C option, that is NASA. This Voyager 1 probe was launched in 1977, and it is transmitting vital data after a period of malfunction, and the spacecraft's mission aims to explore the outer solar system and beyond, conducting flybys of Jupiter and Saturn, and also to discover new moons and rings. So it became the very first human-made object to exit the solar system in 2012, carrying a golden record depicting life on Earth, and Voyager 1 is expected to remain operational until at least 2025. 5. Currently, it is 13.8 billion miles away from the sun. Okay, so Voyager 1 spacecraft belongs to NASA. It is a space probe that has been launched by NASA. Okay, now let's see some space related current affairs. Recently, which country launched their first Angara A5 space rocket? This rocket belongs to Russia. Recently, which space organization has been directed to establish a time standard for the moon called Coordinated Lunar Time? This is NASA. NASA has been directed to establish a time standard for the moon known as Coordinated Lunar Time. Lunar Polar Exploration Mission known as LUPEX, recently seen in the news, is a joint mission between which two space agencies? LUPEX is a joint mission between ISRO and JAXA. Okay. Solar and Heliospheric Observatory named as SOHO, recently seen in the news, is a project of international collaboration between which two space agencies? So this is the international collaboration between European Space Agency and NASA. Which Russian cosmonaut recently set the record for spending the maximum time in space? The name of him is Oleg Kononenko. He is from Russia and recently he set the record for spending the maximum time in space. Which organization recently released a report titled as Towards a Regenerative Blue Economy, Mapping the Blue Economy? Here, correct answer would be IUCN, that is International Union for Conservation of Nature. They have released this particular report where they proposed a definition and principles of a regenerative blue economy. Actually, this model aims for effective regeneration and protection of ocean ecosystem along with sustainable economic activities and fair prosperity. Also, it emphasizes protection, restoration and resilience of marine ecosystems, prioritizing inclusion, fairness and indigenous right while excluding the activities like oil extraction and deep sea mining for carbon reduction and ecosystem preservation. Okay, simply we have to remember that this report has been released by an important organization named as International Union for Conservation of Nature, IUCN. Now here our keyword would be report, and in the next slide we will see some of the important reports that were in news. The first question is, recently which organization released a report named as Ensuring Safety and Health at Work in a Changing Climate? This report has been released by International Labour Organization, headquartered lies in Geneva. State of the Climate in Asia 2023 report, recently seen in the news, is released by which organization? This report has been published by World Meteorological Organization. Global Financial Stability report, recently released by which organization? This report has been published by International Monetary Fund. Global Trade Outlook and Statistics report, recently released by which organization? Answer is World Trade Organization. According to a report released by WADA, that is World Anti-Doping Agency, which country reported the highest number of doping cases in the world? So maximum number of doping cases came out from the country India. Okay. Next is, which Indian naval sailing vessel recently marked a historic transoceanic expedition of nearly 2 months by two women officers of the Indian Navy? So Indian naval sailing vessel INSV Tarini completed a significant transoceanic journey which is led by two female officers, culminating in its return to Goa after nearly 2 months. So during the expedition, the crew engaged with Mauritian officials and collaborated with the Mauritius Coast Guard, which bolsters the bilateral relation. And this achievement underscores the Indian Navy's commitment to gender equality and the women's empowerment in the maritime roles, right? And next, the crew is gearing up for Sagar Parikrama 4, which is a global circumnavigation expedition that is set for September 2024 aboard this INSV Tarini. Okay, correct answer is A option, INSV Tarini. Here our keyword is women, and let's see some women empowerment related current affairs. Recently, who became the first woman vice chancellor of Aligarh Muslim University? So this is Naima Khatun. Professor Naima Khatun is the first woman vice chancellor of Aligarh Muslim University. Recently, who has been appointed as the first woman high commissioner to India by Britain? This is Lindy Cameron. She is the first woman high commissioner to India by Britain. Jyoti Sumanwa Tuluka, recently seen in the news, became the first woman prime minister of which country? She is the first woman prime minister of Democratic Republic of Congo. Recently, who became the first woman sniper of Border Security Force? This is Suman Kumari. Suman Kumari is the very first woman sniper of the BSF. Recently, which state or the union territory conducted all women maritime surveillance mission? This mission, this surveillance mission has been conducted by Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Recently, which country has appointed Colonel Addison Napio as the first defense advisor of India? This is Papua New Guinea country. They have named Colonel Addison Napio as its inaugural defense advisor to India, which signifies the deepening cooperation between the two nations, right? And acting chief of defense force commander Philip Polevara led the farewell ceremony for Napio, who will serve as a liaison between PNG's government and military in India, right? So he is the first to hold this position, and basic aim is to facilitate the training and diplomatic engagement. Okay, so Commander Polevara emphasized representing the PNG effectively during the Napio's deployment. Simply, we have to remember that Papua New Guinea has appointed Colonel Addison Napio as the first defense advisor of India. Now let's talk about some of the important and the recent appointments. Recently, who has been appointed as the Director General of the National Security Guard? This is Nalin Prabhat. He is the new DG of National Security Guard. Recently, who has been appointed as the next Chief of Naval Staff? Answer would be Dinesh Kumar Tripathi. Okay. Recently, who has been appointed as the Joint Director in the CBI? Answer is Mr. Anurag Kumar. Who has become the first Indian to be appointed as a jury member at the 33rd Summer Olympics 2024 to be held in Paris? This is Bilqis Mir. She is the very first Indian to be appointed as a jury member at the 33rd Summer Olympics, which is to be held in Paris. Recently, who has been appointed as the new ambassador of India to the country Myanmar? This is Mr. Abhay Thakur. Okay. Which bank recently unveiled its Climate Strategy 2030 document, which aims to address India's need for green financing? So on Earth Day, the NABARD has revealed their Climate Strategy 2030 targeting India's green financing requirement, and the key pillars include, for example, accelerating the green lending, means green lending would be increased or accelerated, then broadening the market making roles, internal transformation and resource mobilization. So India needs approximately $170 billion annually to achieve a cumulative total of over $2.5 trillion by the end of 2030. Only they have received $49 billion in green financing as of 2019 to 2020. So most of the funds focuses on mitigation with minimal allocation to adaptation and resilience, which is hindered by the limited private sector engagement, right? So NABARD has unveiled their Climate Strategy 2030 document. Basic aim is to address India's need for green financing. What is the full form of NABARD? It stands for the National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development, right? Now let's see some banking related current affairs. The first question is, which bank has recently collaborated with RBI to revolutionize agricultural lending through digitalization? This is again NABARD. NABARD has collaborated with RBI so that they can revolutionize their agricultural lending through digital process. According to the recent ADB report, Asian Development Bank report, what is the expected growth rate of the Indian economy in 2024 to 2025? As per this report, the expected growth rate of Indian economy is about 7%. Recently, which bank became the first private bank to open a branch in Lakshadweep? This is HDFC Bank. It is the very first private bank that has opened a branch in Lakshadweep. Recently, who has been elected as chairman of Indian Bank Association? Answer would be Mr. MVV Rao. Recently, RBI has imposed a penalty of 1.4 crore rupees on which bank? Recently, RBI has imposed this much amount of penalty on Bank of India. Okay. Now, last question is, what is the theme of World Malaria Day 2024? World Malaria Day is observed annually on 25th of April, and this year the theme is accelerating the fight against malaria for a more equitable world. So malaria is transmitted through mosquito bites, and it manifests with symptoms like shaking, chills and high fever. It is prevalent in tropical regions, but it can be preventable with precautions. So this day aims to raise awareness about the prevention methods and combat the disease's impact, right? So World Malaria Day is observed on 25th of April, and this year the theme is accelerating the fight against malaria for a more equitable world. Now let's see some days and themes. Which day is celebrated as National Panchayati Raj Day? Answer is 24th of April. Every year National Panchayati Raj Day is celebrated on 24th of April, marking the enactment of 73rd Constitutional Amendment Act in the year 1993, and this amendment established a three-tier system of local governance with Panchayati Raj institutions at the village, block and the district levels. So it is organized by Ministry of Panchayati Raj, and this day honors the grassroots democracy, right? What is the theme of World Book and Copyright Day? So first of all, we celebrate this day on 23rd of April, and this year the theme was Read Your Way. Okay, which day is celebrated as National Civil Service Day every year? This day is celebrated on 21st of April. Which day is celebrated as World Hemophilia Day every year? This day is observed on 17th of April. And last is, what is the theme of World Immunization Week 2024? First of all, this week is celebrated annually on 24th of April up to 30th of April to highlight the importance of vaccine. Okay, and it was established by the World Health Assembly in 2012. Now it spans in more than 180 countries. This year, the theme is Humanly Possible Immunization for All. This was the theme. Okay. So this theme emphasizes universal access to the vaccines, and the vaccination campaigns have eradicated smallpox and nearly eliminated the polio. So this type of thing actually contribute to global immunization efforts, right? So here correct answer is Humanly Possible Immunization for All. So these are the most important current affairs and the news from today. And now let's start with today's quiz. Here on the slide you can see 5 questions which have been taken from the past 2-3 days current affairs. Pause the video and try to solve each of these questions, and at the end of the lecture, do not forget to share your scores in the comment section. So please be honest and do not cheat with yourself. So that's it for today. I hope you have liked the session. These were the important news and events from today, and we will meet again tomorrow with some more important current affairs. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching, and please do not forget to subscribe to GK Today. With this, Meenu Jhansana signing off.